O sing a new song to the Lord, sing to the Lord all the earth. In his presence are majesty and splendor, strength and honor in his holy place. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
This Mass is offered as the octave of prayer for Christian unity very nearly reaches its close. Tomorrow will be the end of the octave. For the unity of all Christians, we pray in particular for the Christian communities of this area. We pray for the 16 villages and hamlets which make up this Catholic parish and for the Christian presences in those communities. And we pray particularly here in Goring for the Reverend Ben Phillips and for his people at St Thomas's, Pastor Nigel Gordon Potts and for his congregation at the Free Church. We pray for the parish of St Leonard's in Woodcote and for Linda and for her people. And we pray for all those who confess the faith of Christ crucified. My dear friends, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son we may abound in good works. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. A reading from the book of Jonah. The word of the Lord was addressed to Jonah. Up, he said, go to Nineveh, the great city, and preach to them as I told you to. Jonah set out and went to Nineveh in obedience to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was a city great beyond compare. It took 3 days to cross it. Jonah went on into the city, making a day's journey. He preached in these words, only 40 days more and Nineveh is going to be destroyed. And the people in Nineveh believed in God. They proclaimed a fast and put on sackcloth from the greatest to the least. God saw their efforts to renounce their evil behaviour, and God relented. He did not inflict on them the disaster which he had threatened. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, make me know your ways.
Lord, make me know your ways.
Lord, make me know your ways. Lord, teach me your paths. Make me walk in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Saviour.
Lord,
remember your mercy, Lord, and the love you have shown from of old. In your love, remember me because of your goodness, O Lord.
Lord, make me know your ways.
The Lord is good and upright. He shows the path to those who stray. He guides the humble in the right path. He teaches his way to the poor.
Lord, make me know your ways.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers, our time is growing short. Those who have wives should live as though they had none, and those who mourn should live as though they had nothing to mourn for. Those who are enjoying life should live as though they were nothing to laugh about. Those whose life is buying things should live as though they had nothing of their own, and those who have to deal with the world should not become engrossed in it. I say this because the world as we know it is passing away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. The kingdom of God is close at hand. Repent and believe the good news. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After John had been arrested, Jesus went into Galilee. There he proclaimed the good news from God. The time has come, he said, and the kingdom of God is close at hand. Repent and believe the good news. As he was walking along by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net in the lake, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you into fishers of men." And at once they left their nets and followed him. Going on a little further, he saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They too were in their boat, mending their nets. He called them at once, and leaving their father Zebedee in the boat with the men he employed, they went after him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Normally, I don't think I'd preach a long homily to a church with millions of angels present, but not quite so many human beings. However, I am very aware that there are friends joining us over the internet, particularly friends from Woodcote, and again, it's a sort of double whammy, if you like, that the problems with the roof and last week, until last Monday, I wasn't really aware, none of us were aware, quite how wonky the roof was, to use the word I used on last week's sheet. Wonky, I think, has now turned to dodgy, and at one stage it was unsafe. Although, thanks to our builders, it's been propped up, but I think probably best not to try and offer mass in what is basically a building site at the moment. Still, we gather, nevertheless, in whatever way we manage to gather, to pray together on the Lord's Day, in the Lord's house, at the Lord's altar, and to fulfil the Lord's command. And the church gives us those three readings. Jonah. Jonah, of course, most famous for being Jonah and the whale. Can't help but feel that our modern translation loses something, just a little of the magic, perhaps, by calling it Jonah and the big fish. Maybe that's a better translation of the Hebrew. My Hebrew, it's been a long time since my Hebrew's been any good at all. But Jonah and the whale is somehow set into our consciousness and those stories that we learned when we were so high. And then that curious passage from St. Paul about the world as we know it being coming towards its end, and that there is no time to worry about what we've been worried about before. And there, that third reading, the Gospel reading, about the call of Andrew and Simon, soon to be given the nickname Peter, James and John, after whom this church is dedicated, at least in part, along with Our Lady. And of course we remember at that moment the words of Jesus on the cross, "Woman, behold your son, behold your mother," at the moment when Jesus gives Our Lady and St. John the Evangelist to each other. The call. The call is an immediate one. St. Mark tells the story with almost breathless excitement and a rush. St. Mark doesn't give us that sort of interior monologue which a modern novelist might. And perhaps we might be tempted to put into the characters in the Gospel story a narrative, conversations that presumably did happen, but which St. Mark hasn't given us. What was it, for example, that Zebedee said when James and John downed tools and disappeared from their daily work? I imagine it possibly wasn't particularly peaceful or ironic at first. But we don't really need to know, and it's a bit of a blind alley to try and reconstruct the other conversations of that day. The conversation we need to know is very short, and actually it's a one-sided one, at least in words. It's a conversation that goes, "Follow me, I will make you fishers of men." And the conversation from the other side is a wordless one, as far as we know from St. Mark. Immediately, the fishermen leave Jesus, leave their nets and follow Jesus to go they know not where. And of course, for those of us who have been lucky enough to go to Rome, some of us lucky enough to go to Rome more than once, outside St. Peter's Basilica is the obelisk moved to its present position in the 16th century, but which very well may have been the last thing that St. Peter saw as he was being martyred. His eyes may well have closed to the sight of that particular obelisk. Could Simon, Shimeon, the fisherman there in Galilee, have imagined where following the call of Jesus was going to lead? And so the important thing is that Christianity is based not on a holy book. It is based not on a system of theological or philosophical argument. It is based not on great works of art and architecture and music. All of those things are wonderful and they all point us to Jesus. But the Christian faith is at heart about none of those, but about a person, about the second person of the Trinity, the Son of God, sharing our humanity, to take our humanity to the heavenly realms. And thus it is that we follow. We are called by a person. We follow a voice. And of course that comes to us in different ways, in a million and more different ways, as the world turns on its axis. There will be some called to high office. During this last week we have seen somebody given power which is probably unimaginable to the vast majority of the human race. We have seen one person who has held that power for the last 4 years now fade from the picture, and another person take up that baton, called to high office. There will be some who remember hearing, and others who have heard it subsequently, the broadcast that the Queen made on her 21st birthday to the Empire, to the Commonwealth and to the nation about service, a calling for one in 60-something million of us, and a calling she has lived out for 70-something years now with remarkable devotion. We are called to follow. And if it's not a bad pun, we can turn that word fisher round. Not because it's a bad pun on our part, but because Jesus did it first. The fishermen became fishermen not of fish, but of human beings. But only after they had themselves been caught. They had been captured. They were captives of Jesus in the gentlest way possible. And so it is that we share their calling in our own ways. We must allow ourselves to be captured by Jesus. We must not let any of those things of this world, of which St. Paul wrote in our second reading, keep us back from that. Like Jonah, it is that point where we are caught, that we are not entrapped, but we are embraced to be preachers, like Jonah, like Simon Peter, Andrew, James and John. Preachers not so much, as St. John Henry Newman was always saying in that famous meditation, not so much by what we say, by what we do and what we are. Preachers of him, who on the Galilean lakeside, in the middle of a working day, 20 centuries ago, called those first four disciples and who continues to call us to his service and in the service of his glory. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church. Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty, and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise, as we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given. similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have sent us and held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Bernard our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I would invite those of you joining in this Mass, praying this Mass over the internet, to pray the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you in Holy Communion now, at least come spiritually into my heart. As if you have already come to me, I embrace you and join myself wholly to you. Do not allow me to distance myself from you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Thanks be to God. The angel of the Lord brought tidings to Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Ghost. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Be it unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us. The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Beseech thee, O Lord, pour thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his passionate cross we may be brought to the door of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. May the divine assistance remain with us always, and may the souls of the faithful, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.